Well done, you've mastered that trick of turning the tape over. Here we are on side two. So, Chloe, do you have another question for me?
Yes. Why did you give Thomas his very own branch line?
Ah, well, I can remember that. One day, when Thomas was working in the station yard, James whooshed past in a terrible state. James's brake blocks were on fire, and to those naughty rascals, the troublesome trucks were pushing him. My splendid red engine was thrown right off the line, and if it hadn't been for Thomas and the breakdown train, the trucks wouldn't have been brought back in disgrace to the station yard, and poor old James would still be laying by the side of the track. As a result of Thomas's splendid efforts, I was delighted to give the little blue engine his very own branch line. Of course, Thomas could never be as fast or strong as my other engines, but he continues to be really useful all the same.
Is Thomas your favourite engine, then?
Oh, good heavens, no. I have countless engines at Soda Railways, perhaps as many as 50, and Thomas proudly displays a number one on his side. However, this does not mean I prefer Thomas to the likes of Edward or Henry, Gordon, James or Percy. My engines are as different as you or me, and provided they listen to me and try their hardest to be really useful, they are all my favourites.
Who is the naughtiest engine at Soda Railways?
Oh, well, that's quite easy, really. It has to be Devious Diesel. Bill and Ben, mind you, who work between the Soda China Clay Company and the harbour, are always teasing the others, and Thomas and Percy are cheeky little chaps. But Devious Diesel is very, very mean, and whenever I see that smirk on his face, I know somebody somewhere is in for a bit of trouble. Who's got the next question?
Hello, my name's Ben. Why do you think Diesel is so mean?
Ooh, well, I suppose that's because he thinks my steam engines are old-fashioned and should be scrapped. Pomp my soul, when he first arrived, Diesel told Duck that he didn't need to learn anything because he had come to the station yard to improve things. Needless to say, I did not stand for Diesel's nonsense.
Are all your Diesel engines as bad as Devious Diesel?
Oh, no, no, no. Boko, for example, is a decent diesel with a good sense of humour. And Little Rusty will do almost anything to please the steam engines. Devious Diesel is by far the worst. Although the yellow diesels, who tried to take Stepney to be melted down, can also be cruel.
Hello, my name's Emily. When your engines are very naughty, how do you punish them?
Well, I tell them off. Or I send them to sulk in the engine sheds for a couple of days. However, I never hit them, because violence never solves any problems. Besides, the Train Spotters Society for Prevention of Cruelty to Engines, well, they demand my sacking if I hit an engine.
What's the silliest thing that an engine's done on your railway?
Oh, that has to be Henry. A long and fast engine, Henry once refused to come out of a tunnel in case the rain spoilt his lovely green paint and red boiler stripes. Henry's driver and fireman tried to get him out of the tunnel, and when he also refused to listen to me, I asked the men to tear up the rails and build a brick wall in front of Henry. Naturally, Henry was very sad watching the other engines whoosh past, but at least he's no longer afraid of a little bit of rain. Sir Emily, do you have another question for me?
Yes. What's the best thing you've ever done at Soda Railways?
Yes. I've got so many happy memories, it's very difficult to choose just one thing. I'm always very proud and happy when my engines are really useful and look after the passengers. But my most splendid memory must be when the Queen came to visit. On that grand day, Percy, Toby, Henry and James all worked very hard bringing people to town, whilst Thomas sorted out all the coaches in the yard. Edward travelled just before the royal train to clear the line, and Gordon proudly pulled the royal carriage into the station. Well, you should have seen Gordon. He was polished beautifully. His brass gleamed in the sunshine, and he was decorated with flags, and the royal coat of arms was on his buffer beam. Gordon looked splendid. I was asked to welcome Her Majesty to my railway, and she was delighted to meet all my engines. Thomas, Percy and all the other engines smiled with pride when they met her, but I was even prouder. Splendid.
Finally, what are you going to do when you retire?
Retire? Puh! There's plenty more years left in the old dog yet. Thomas and the other engines aren't going to get rid of me that easily. But don't tell Lady Hatt. She's already talking about a little house by the sea. Oh, excuse me a minute. Hello, Soda Railways. I beg your pardon. Trouble with the turntables? Poor Gordon spinning around very fast. OK, I'm on my way. Goodness me, I'm sorry, but there's an emergency and I must dash. Thank you very much, all of you, for coming. That's Chloe, Emily, Jonathan and Ben, but I really must dash now. Thomas sends you his cheerful beep beep, and all my other engines send you their best wishes. Or should I say, wishes? I hope you like the whistle, collector's cards and all the other items in the club welcome pack. And don't forget to send me your engine drawings for stamping. Your club poster has details of what to do. Well, I must be going, so bye-bye, everybody, and have a jolly useful time.